What is up, fellas? Ladies and gentlemen of YouTube, welcome back to the channel. My name is Tim. Thanks so much for stopping by. Appreciate it. In the background today, you're going to be seeing two gameplays. One is on Nuketown. The other is on Nuketown. Yes, they're both on Nuketown. Bruh. Why did I say it like that? What the heck? But anyway, they're both hardcore Nuketown games. I'm using different guns. I think one's the type. The other is, I think, an LMG. I don't really remember. I think I get like a 2KD in each of them, so it is what it is. I'm not here to impress anyone. These are not reverse boosted. I don't know if I have to come out and say that in front of every video now because of what's going on in the COD community, but just to let you guys know, these are not reverse boosted gameplays. Unless you consider me just sucking at the game reverse boosting, then in which case they are. Probably pretty evident and obvious what I'm going to talk about in today's video, but before we start, let's talk about the subscribe button. I need you to hit that real quick, and while you're down there, give a slap to the like button, alright? Like, the like button has really just not been doing his homework. I need you to slap him, you know, set him straight, and I'd really appreciate if you could help me out with that. Okay, now let's talk about chain feeds. So, I didn't want to talk about this, right? If you're a real fan of mine, and you watched yesterday's video to the entirety, like, because I talked about chain feeds at the very end there, you will know that I did not want to mention this. I didn't want to talk about chain feeds in particular because, like I said in yesterday's video, he was nothing but polite to me. He was nothing but nice. He gave me a beta code. He replies to tweets. He likes my tweets. He followed me back. Like, there's nothing that, you know, really bugged me about him. On a person-to-person level interaction, he's never pissed me off. He's never done anything wrong. He's never crossed me in any way. So I didn't really want to just kind of bash on this because of, you know, it's the popular thing to do because it gets clicks. And obviously, if you're listening and paying attention right now, by the thumbnail and title, you'll know that I am mentioning him. And the reason why I wanted to mention him before I tell this whole story of, you know, if you don't know what's going on, the reason why I'm okay talking about it now is because I think he did a good thing. I think he did several bad things, but I also think he did a good thing at the end. And this is kind of why I wanted to talk about it, because I think there's a lesson learned here, right? There's something we can all take away from this. It's not just, skill-based matchmaking is bad, but the entire process, which I will lay out for you if you're completely new to this whole chain feed drama or whatever, which I don't know if you're watching me for the first time, but you know, if you're new to it, you know, welcome. It's story time over here with Tim's channel. But I do think that there's a lot to be learned from this situation, and I'm really excited to kind of share my takeaways from this entire thing, because no matter how you spin it, this entire chain feeds and SBMM and reverse boosting thing has caused some of the best videos I've seen on YouTube in a while in terms of Call of Duty content, right? In terms of Call of Duty commentaries, we have great commentators coming out of like everywhere, you know, GG Reloaded, 8Thoughts, Blame Truth, Thunder, JB, Murder Show, like so many people just talking about this, and it's great. You know, it's awesome to hear the COD community just kind of rising up and talking and banding together. It's not necessarily that we're banding against chain feeds or gameplay channels in general, but just banding together in hopes of improving the game altogether. And I think either way, you know, if you're on chain feed side, if you're on Blame Truth side or whatever, or Average Old Gaming side rather, either way, both sides want to see skill-based matchmaking removed. That's the ultimate issue at hand right now. And just how people are running their channels is kind of where the debate is, right? And just kind of actions on both sides. So let's talk about it. So if you already know this part might not be interesting, but I'm going to try to throw in some jokes or something here and there. I want to spice up the commentaries, you know. I don't want to just be an average Joe here. I want to, you know, give my two cents on everything. But if you do know everything already, this part might not be the most interesting, but stick around anyway, you know, why not? So chain feeds, and obviously a lot of other people, Paradox, and, you know, I don't even know, a lot of gameplay channels out there. And by gameplay channels, I mean predominantly just people who go 100-0, people who drop a nuke every game, people who drop 40 kills in Warzone. Like, these kinds of people are the kind of people I'm referring to. Not every single person, but a large majority of them, let's just assume, are reverse boosting. Chain feeds, unfortunately, was called out by Average of Gaming. And I say unfortunately because he was the one who, I guess, got caught, you know, like there's a ton of people doing it, but he was the only one who actually got caught in the action of doing it. There's a great video by Average Old Gaming, who I actually was recently in DMs with, hope to be this dude's friend. If you're watching this dude, please be my friend, thanks. But yeah, the dude makes good videos. Anyway, he got copyright struck by chain feeds because of the video that, you know, he called him out on. Obviously upset about this, he made a video and it spread like wildfire, right? Like Blame Truth, 8Thoughts, big YouTubers came out of nowhere in defense of this dude because what he did was, a little sus, a little skeptical or whatever. After all this drama and all this stuff was mentioned about chain feeds, he made a video, and I guess he tweeted about it too, but basically he said he denied reverse boosting. You know, he says, I don't reverse boost, I don't do this and that, and things like that. And it was just, you know, a lot of people were very, very upset with him, to the point where people were dislike bombing his video like crazy. Like, several of his videos ended up getting very dislike bombed. Like, oh my god, like, if it was a KD, it would be like a 0.3 or something. Like, it was a pretty bad look for chain feeds. 2 or 3 days later, chain feeds admits to reverse boosting in a tweet and follows up the next day, which was yesterday, with a video. And in the video, he apologizes to Average Old Gaming. He apologizes to Blame Truth and 8thoughts. He apologizes to his fans for, I guess, lying. And by lying, I guess I mean just lying through the gameplay, lying through, you know, saying that he doesn't reverse boost and things like that. Now, in his video, if you guys remember the timeline here, he denied reverse boosting in a video, and 2 days later he admitted to it, right? So he explains in his video why he denied it, and essentially is because he wanted to draw it out so that there would be more attention thrown on it. I'm not here to speculate on it. Personally, I don't believe that to be fully true. I think if it is true, he definitely wanted a lot of the attention on himself, which was the case, right? If you Google chain feeds or, you know, YouTube chain feeds reverse boosting, there's a ton of videos out there from smaller content creators. A lot of my friends made videos on it. A lot of the bigger dudes made videos on it. So it definitely worked. You know, he definitely got a lot of attention. I think he realized it was negative attention, and so he got to do some damage control. But at the end of the day, I respect him for apologizing, for trying to make amends, and for apologizing to his community. You know, he doesn't have to do these things, but I think he did the right thing. A lot of people were telling me, oh, he was forced to or whatever. Not necessarily. Like, yes, he's quote unquote forced to for the good of his channel, but at the same time, he doesn't have to. He doesn't owe people anything. I think the only thing he owed was getting rid of the copyright strike on Average Old Gaming. I don't think that was justified, and I think everyone, including him, realizes that that was not justified. So personally, at the end of the day, I'm cool with him still. I never was not cool with him. I never really saw an issue with most of the things. I think the most egregious thing that he's done, unfortunately, was copyright strike a smaller YouTuber. I think whenever you try to silence someone in that way, especially like with a mark on their channel, like, which could hurt, you know, advertisement, which could hurt their channel a lot, I don't think that's a good look, no matter how you spin it. You know, there's very few cases in which case a copyright strike is warranted, and it has to be like, in my opinion at least, it would have to be like a direct, like, hey, he copied me word for word, or he copied my gameplay, or, you know, whatever. He copied the title, thumbnail, tags. He copied every single thing. Like, and if you watch Average Old Gaming's video about chain feeds, you realize that there's not a whole lot of room to be copywritten, I guess is the best way to phrase that. Some people are still mad at chain feeds and other reverse boosting channels, but I don't care. You know what I mean? Like, it doesn't matter. If their channels suffer, they suffer. If they don't, they don't. It doesn't hurt me whatsoever. It doesn't bother me. I think it's cool to talk about these things, especially because they're trending topics, and obviously these kinds of videos are going to get views, but they're not like life or death situation. They're not like, oh, this game sucks situation. It's just, it's other people's business that we're just sticking our noses into. You can call me a chain feeds fanboy. You can call me a fence sitter, whatever. Like, this is just how I feel. I don't feel passionately against either side. I only feel passionately against skill-based matchmaking, which I think is the overall key. Some people are going to believe chain feeds, some people aren't. Some people are going to dislike 8thoughts or Blame Truth now, some people aren't. Like, it doesn't matter to me. I'm cool with everyone as long as they're cool with me. You can call me a simp for either side, it doesn't really matter to me. I know where I stand. I think I'm honestly a pretty fair individual when it comes to things like this and situations like this. I think I know, in my opinion, what's right, what's wrong, and I'm willing to stick with that and stick with the people who exhibit that kind of behavior. At the end of the day, I do think a lot of these things are going to be put to rest, and I think a lot of channels have seen a lot of growth. There's a lot of drama in the community right now, and unfortunately that's kind of going down because of all this clarification. But I think this was something that needed to be said. I think skill-based matchmaking is seriously dividing the COD community to quite a degree, to the point where gameplay versus commentary channels are going at each other and making videos on each other. I think skill-based matchmaking is definitely the biggest thing that Call of Duty is facing right now. So before this video ends, I want you guys to let me know what you think about the whole chain feed situation, who's in the right, who's in the wrong. Again, just to reiterate, I think copyright striking people for no reason is wrong. Other than that, it doesn't really bother me too much what people do on their own channels. So that's not to say, like, you know, everyone should get away innocent free or scot free or whatever. I'm just saying everything else doesn't bother me to the same degree as the copyright strike. And again, chain feeds has apologized and helped Average get rid of the copyright strike. So in my book, that's one of the biggest gestures he could have done for the community and for Average Old Gaming himself as well. But anyway, that's going to do it for the video today. I appreciate you guys so much for watching. Make sure to leave a like if you enjoyed. Subscribe if you're new to the channel. I really appreciate it. And make sure to have a good day. I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.